I'm Bryce. Let's do a quick coloring activity.
Let's learn more about images from space telescopes.
So for this activity, we need a coloring key and coloring page, as well as some crayons. To begin with, pick 6 colors. These can be any color you want. Write them down 1 through 6. This will make our coloring kind of like a Mad Libs, only for coloring.
Next, color your coloring page based on the colors you picked.
You might be able to make out what it is supposed to be, but make sure you follow your key.
Here's my final picture. Can you tell what the stuff is?
Usually, we think of an apple being red, but mine is blue.
But what does this have to do with images from space telescopes? Let's ask an expert.
Great job! I'm Elise Pagan. I'm a science visuals developer who works at Space Telescope Science Institute, and we are associated with NASA. We take data from Hubble and other observatories, and we make free pictures of space.
I'm Joe DePasquale. I am also a science visuals developer at the Space Telescope Science Institute. And like Elisa, my work is to take the data from the Hubble Space Telescope and other telescopes and create imagery and visualizations for press releases or outreach products, and pull all that information together to help get the word out about the amazing science that we do at Space Telescope. My job is to take data from the telescope and turn it into imagery. The way that we do that is we actually go into the archive and pull raw data out of the archive of different objects the telescope has observed. It will observe those objects in multiple wavelengths of light. And that's actually sort of the core of where the colors come from, because we take those multiple wavelengths and we assign colors to them. The longest wavelengths are assigned redder colors. And then as we move into shorter wavelengths, we move to blue. And so when we pull all that together and we've assigned those colors accordingly, we end up with a full color image made up of red, green, and blue.
A kind of a true color representation is what we call it. Sometimes we deal with imagery that doesn't have that direct translation. We're dealing with narrow wavelength ranges that are telling us a little bit something more particular or different, kind of like a particular hot gas or dust or composition. And sometimes we have to change that color to get a really interesting image that speaks to the science of what we're looking at.
So the challenge with infrared light is we need to take sort of the same model of coloring that we use for optical and transfer it into infrared. So we expect to get data from the Webb telescope that will have shorter wavelengths of infrared light and longer wavelengths of infrared light. And in general, we'll apply the same principles of giving shorter wavelengths bluer colors and longer wavelengths redder colors to then combine all the data together to make color images.
Alyssa and Joe, how did I do?
The coloring that you did really connects to what we do.
There's very specific colors attributed to certain phenomenon or particular filters, just like in the picture where it's just sky is one color. And then you had like the ground is one color and the sun is one color. You know just by that color that you're seeing that you're looking at the sky. And it's the same thing with things like if you're looking at a galaxy and you know, oh, that magenta, that's where star forming is happening. Or, oh, that's blue in that galaxy. That must be a really hot young star. So it is very similar. And when you color code it in that way, you can learn a lot.
Let us know what your favorite part of this video was in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. Also, you can follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and be sure to subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.